That's to integration by parts for the integral of arc sine x to the second power. And let me show you with the DI method. We are going to be encountering strange things, but it's okay. Let me show you how it goes. Anyways, for the DI method, it says I'm going to pick something to be differentiated and then something to be integrated. And we only have one thing right here, arc sine x to the second power. Let's put that to be differentiated. So under the D column, we have arc sine x to the second power. And under the I column, we have 1. And don't forget the sign in front, plus, minus. And 2 rows is enough for now. Let's get to work to differentiate this guy, bring the 2 to the front, and then the inside stays the same for now. Arc sine x, and then you look at the inside. Ask yourself the derivative inside is what? Because the chain rule, we have to multiply by the derivative of that, which is 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. We're done for that. Let's integrate the 1, which we get x. And the question is, should we keep going or should we stop? And the answer for that is, we need to stop, because if you want to keep going, this is going to be bigger and bigger, right? This is actually enough. And another thing is that the product of this is actually something that we know how to do. Okay, let me show you. Okay, so let's stop right here. But then the product of the diagonal is going to be the answer. Let's do it. So here, I'm going to get x times that, x times arc sine x to the second power. And then each row, the product of each row, it's still an integral. Okay? So here we have minus 2. Let me just put the negative 2 in the front. We have minus 2, the integral of the product of these things. Let me write down arc sine x first right here. This is arc sine x times, we have 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared times x. Let's put the x on the top. So we have x over square root of 1 minus x squared, and then we have dx, of course. We actually know how to integrate this. But then we have to use the integration by parts for this. We have to use integration by parts for this again. And the problem for this is why I mentioned in the previous video why the DI method doesn't work out the way that you want it to be, like no magic or so magic or things like that. The reason is we have to set up the DI method for this particular integral. Okay, so this right here, it was done. I cannot continue the choice of this column. Okay, I have to set up another DI method for this, for that. So we can totally do that. Pick something to be differentiated, pick something to integrate it. We have 2 things, arc sine x, and then x over square root of 1 minus x squared. Maybe we should worry about what should we pick to be integrated. So ask yourself, can you integrate that? Yes, we can, but then we have to do integration part for that. So let's not integrate that. How about, can I integrate that x over square root of 1 minus x squared? And the answer to that is yes, and we just need u substitution. Okay, so let's pick this to be integrated, x over square root of 1 minus x squared, and then let's differentiate arc sine x. Okay, and once again, let's get a plus minus ready. And in this case, 2 rows is enough again. Anyways, let's differentiate this. We get 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. That's very nice. And let's integrate this. And here you have to do u substitution. Do that u is equal to 1 minus x squared. And let me just tell you what the answer is. The answer to this is negative square root of 1 minus x squared. And then, should we stop or should we keep going? Remember, the second situation is that if you know the product of each row, if that's something that you can integrate, what's the product of this? 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared and negative square root of 1 minus x squared. They will cancel out, right? The product of this is just 1. We can totally integrate 1. We can stop right here. Okay, so to construct the answer, it's a product of the diagonal. And let me just put like a parenthesis inside for this integral, okay? So now let's just ignore everything else, just focus on that. This is going to give me arc sine x times that. Let me put down this first. So we have negative square root 1 minus x squared times arc sine x, okay? And then we kind of have to worry about the product. So we have, by the way, this is what? Negative times a negative So it's a plus integral of what? 1 over this times that. Luckily, they are the same. So they cancel out. It's just 1 dx. Okay? And of course, this right here is nothing but just an x. This is just an x. So we know this right here is just equal to x. And now we have the negative in the front and this guy in the front. So to finish this up, let me just write this down here. X times arc sine x square. But then for this part, I will have to take the negative 2 and distribute it inside. Let's do it. Negative 2 times that. Negative 2 times that is negative negative, become positive 2 square root of 1 minus x squared arc sine x. And then negative 2 times positive x, which is minus 2x. And we are done. Let's put plus c. And this is it. Okay? So in this situation, you still kind of do the DI method, but this is just the same as the traditional setup. Okay? So it may be strange, but then it works. This is it.